In this demonstration, we will be showing you Vonage for Bullhorn, the latest offering from Vonage Integration Suite that allows you to tie your Vonage Business Communications phone directly to the Bullhorn CRM. Let's take a look. The Vonage Integration Suite is available on multiple browser platforms, including Google Chrome, Firefox, and Microsoft Edge. In Chrome, for example, you would go to the web extension store and download the Vonage Integration Suite and sign in with the unique code provided by email. Once logged in, you can simply click on the icon to open the Integration Suite window. You can see here across the top, I have several tabs available. The first being the history. This will show me all of my interaction between a customer or candidate in Bullhorn and the phone system. You can see when a single match or multiple matches found that it will list a contact in here. However, if there is no one found, it will just show you the phone number. You can also see that I have stored notes available to me in here, and it's clearly indicated how many I have, and I can simply click on the icon to see those notes. The next button is your favorites. This allows you to store candidate information in your favorites so that you can more quickly contact them by simple click to dial. You can also leverage the dial pad to dial their number manually or copy and paste. You can connect other productivity suites or CRMs into the Vonage integration system, as you can see here. However, this demonstration will be only covering Bullhorn. Below, you have additional features that you can add to the system to give you extra functionality, like enabling your click to dial or leveraging the web launcher to open an additional page on an inbound or outbound call. Speech recognition allows you to use a microphone to dictate into the notes section inside of the integration suite to more quickly store your information. You also have an announcements section, which will give you notifications about upcoming or current integration upgrades, as well as a feedback section to provide your feedback to our product team on your experience with Vonage Integration Suite for Bullhorn or any feature enhancements you'd like to see. You also have your profile button, which allows you to more quickly advance to the admin web portal so that you can see metrics and information about calls, which we will cover later in this demo. You have a user reporting feature. So if you are an end user and not an admin, you can see your call reporting and metrics. You have your account information, which allows you to see how you're logged in through the Vonage Business Communication System and what account it's tied to in Bullhorn. You also have your settings, which allows you to go in and customize more granularly what your Vonage Integration Suite looks like on your desktop. For example, I can modify my pop-up activity window so that I only answer calls and get a pop-up on an inbound call or an outbound call. I can easily and dynamically change these during the course of calling, hit save and close, and the next call, it will pop up with the activity that I selected. I can also go in and exclude certain URLs from click to dial if I don't want to see the click to dial icon. I can also modify my window appearance. So if I don't want to receive desktop notifications on an inbound call, I can turn that off. I can make my panel or my activity window smaller or customized. So let's take a look at the actual pop-up window. When a call comes in, you will get an activity pop if you've programmed it to do so, and it will present me with the Bullhorn information. In here, I can set appointments, I can set tasks, or I can set notes directly from inside the integration suite without ever having to log into Bullhorn. I also have the capability to add candidates inside the system so that I can more quickly synchronize my system if I need to. If I want to look at the candidate information directly in Bullhorn, I can simply click on this icon, which we will cover in just a moment. Or I can click on the actual record to show this actual comment in the system. I also have the ability to click on my history, which will show me any additional interactions that I've had with this particular candidate or customer inside the system. This only pertains to my interaction, and I am unable to see my other user's interaction from this window. However, I can simply go back and click on the candidate and open it in Bullhorn so that I can see that information more quickly. I also have the capability to control the call while I'm in this window. I can start the call if I get disconnected. I can end the call, put them on hold, or transfer the call at any time. The home button allows you to more quickly create your note tasks and appointments if, for example, you found a multiple matching candidate for a particular phone number. This could be common if you had multiple candidates working from a specific building or multiple contacts from a business that are hiring you to find them candidates. They may be presenting the same caller ID, so you can quickly drag and drop the appropriate name into the activity that you want to create. Let's go back and take a look at the actual system and see what this looks like. If I click on my candidate, it's going to open in Bullhorn. You can see here that it is redirecting me because I was not logged in prior. So inside of the system, I can actually see all of my open tasks. I can go into my notes and see all of the notes that I've stored from the Vonage Integration Suite system. I can also look at all activities by task, appointments, or notes. These are all generated and stored for you directly into the candidate or company's information or account. The next thing we want to take a look at would be an example of an appointment. If I wanted to generate an appointment in here, I can actually go in and type their name. I can add additional contacts to this, and it will email that out to the additional contacts that are going to participate. Place a description in here. If I click the speech recognition button, you can clearly see that it dictates what I'm saying during the course of this demo. That's all I need to do in order to generate that system. We hope you've enjoyed the basic demonstration of the Bullhorn capabilities, but now we want to go ahead and take a look at the more advanced features. Let's take a look at the reporting. So from the administrative web portal, I have the capability to do several things. First of all, I can go in and I can look at my call summary, which shows me the intervals of all of my users using the integration. So I can more clearly see total inbound and outbound calls, as well as my total duration. But more importantly, if you notice at the bottom, I can see in the graph my highs and lows for my activities. This is a great way to leverage this as a forecasting tool to ensure that you have the proper staffing in place if you notice that you're getting consistent spikes at a certain time of day. If I want to see specific users, I can click on the Users tab, and I can simply type in the information to filter out additional users if I have a large team of people. I can also click up here, and that will eliminate those. In the Summary section, I can filter my reporting by specific dates and times, as well as direction, interval, and I can also set this to automatically refresh if I want to put this up on a screen in my call center to use it as a wall board. The call detail records allows me to see all of the listed contacts and call information from my users. The difference here is that I can now identify the contact, so I no longer have to guess which phone number belongs to which candidate or company. I can also export this information into a CSV file, which allows me to create pivot tables, graphs, etc. Inside the My Account information, this allows me to do several things. I can see which users have actually connected, which users are active. I can click on their information and see their call history. I can also, more importantly, go in and modify the view of that pop-up. So if I have different groups of people that need to collect different information during the course of a call, I can customize that. So the first step is to click on the name Bullhorn. This allows me to set my default activity type, and it also allows me to go in and tell the system how it's going to operate. Auto-logging zero duration calls, for example, would be helpful if people were calling you, but you still wanted to log the fact that they called. Or if I want to auto-log a single matching contact, this is helpful so that if I do nothing but take the call and I don't have my screen pops activated, it will still log the fact that I spoke to that person. Step two involves clicking on the next icon, which allows me to set where I want to actually synchronize my contacts from. Do I want to look in my leads, my client contacts, and my candidates? You may have additional areas based on your use case of Bullhorn. The same goes for your activities at the bottom. What type of activities do you want them to be able to do? Do you want them to be able to do notes and tasks and appointments, or tasks only? You can dynamically change this and it will push that out on the next activity type for those users. The third and final step is clicking on the wrench. This will put you into the custom builder mode, which allows you to build templates based off of the information you need to collect from your candidates or customer accounts. In this case, I'm going to go in and look at tasks. This will load all of the fields that are available to me in my instance of Bullhorn. And now I can quickly and easily drag and drop to change the order of the fields. I can click on my gear, which will allow me to set it as a required field or always visible, or if I want to exclude it altogether. This does not affect the activity inside of the Bullhorn CRM itself. It only affects what you see in the pop-up inside of the integration suite. Once I have customized this, I can simply give it a custom name in the layout section and hit create. Once I've done this, it will now allow me to go into the system when I go into tasks, and I can click on my dropdown, and it will allow me to automatically modify those fields as I see fit. Once that field has been changed, it will remain that way until the end user changes it again. I hope you've enjoyed this demonstration of the Vonage Integration Suite for Bullhorn.